NBC2 is tracking how tonight's rain and high winds have impacted you. Let's take a live look at a power outage map. A few hundred homes still don't have power across Southwest Florida, but it's a big improvement from earlier when it was more than 1,000 customers left in the dark.
Tonight we're bringing you team coverage from across Southwest Florida. NBC2's Madison Adams is live on Fort Myers Beach, which is under a coastal flood watch tonight. Madison?
Yes, Peter, I've seen some pretty high tides on Fort Myers Beach and Sanibel this evening. Right now, we're under a coastal flood watch until early tomorrow morning. Right now, this is Bahia Villa Street on Fort Myers Beach. As you can see, this street is flooded, but it's a lot better than it was 45 minutes ago. The flood is starting to go back down through the storm drains, and it is getting better out here, thankfully. What are you guys doing out here tonight in this storm?
Trying to catch something.
Tonight, Chris Silva and his buddy are doing something that they do often, fishing underneath the Sanibel Causeway. How higher is the tide than normal?
Well, right now he's really high. So normally he's not this high. He stay right back there on the rocks.
Tonight, the tide is much higher than usual. The Sanibel boat ramp and dock is almost completely underwater.
I don't think it's going to be the best either for fishing. I don't recommend it.
These two men are just a few of many who crave the bad weather.
Bad? Well, this is perfect weather. What are you talking about?
This is
what we live
for boating, but this is what we, yeah, this is basically the weather that we look forward to.
Windsurfers and kiteboarders tell us that today's weather is heaven.
Flying. It's just flying and flying across the water, and then jumping in the air is like, it's a magical gift from God to be on the water and jump in his air. And it's awesome.
As a result of tonight's weather, construction crews who are working on repairing the Sanibel Causeway after part of it was destroyed during Hurricane Ian have moved their equipment and material to higher ground as a precaution.
No, they're pretty secure. They're doing a good job. They're doing a really good job.
Really secure.
Yeah, it's going faster than we thought. Really.
Yeah, but the causeway has always been our go-to spot. That they're out there is good. I mean, we want to hear that they're out there 24/7. Get that project done.
The Florida Department of Transportation tells me that work on the causeway will be finished mid-2025. Tonight, they'll have crews there overnight monitoring conditions. Count on NBC2 to bring you the latest weather coverage tonight with more updates. I'm live here on Fort Myers Beach, Madison Adams, NBC2.